The Detroit Red Wings draft preview show on Fox Sports Detroit is presented to you by the Henry Ford. One of these days, the hockey gods will wink at Detroit if they find themselves in the NHL draft lottery again, but you can't worry about what hasn't happened. You embrace what's about to happen. The hope is that those days are over and that now the Wings, with an infusion of youth, are headed toward regular playoff season. Hi, everybody. Welcome inside Little Caesars Arena. We're in the Red Wings dressing room, and we're looking mightily toward the future. Welcome to our draft preview special. I'm John Keating of Fox Sports Detroit, along with Art Regner of DetroitRedWings.com, Ken Daniels, the longtime play-by-play voice of the Detroit Red Wings, and our hockey reporter at Fox Sports Detroit, Trevor Thompson. The NHL draft is June 21st and 22nd in Vancouver, guys. The Wings have turned a page rather appropriately at this point of the calendar year, and now they're looking forward to what might be the next wave. Art, I'll start with you. As we look at the potential that exists in this draft pool, what's the level of excitement for Red Wing fans?
Well, I think they should be really excited. I think that this is really a lot of high-end talent in the forward core. Unfortunately, I think if Steve Yzerman had his druthers, so to speak, he'd like to see this draft be full of premium defensemen, because that's what they really need, is that they need to rebuild the blue line in the defensive core. But I think with the number six pick overall, I think without question what they're going to end up getting is a very high-end, highly skilled forward.
Kenny?
Same, because of where they're picking at six. They didn't think a year ago Filip Zadina would fall to six, and that wasn't their main point of view was a winger, but that's what happened. So I think at six they would maybe love a Bowen Byram to fall to six, but there are a lot of skilled centermen, terrific skating centermen down the middle. I think they're going to get one of those two at number six.
We're going to talk more about the specifics that exist, but overall, Trev, the pool that exists, I think it hurts that the Wings aren't picking one or two where everybody wanted them to pick, but there is a really good player to be had at six.
Yeah, there really is, and they're talking with Chris Draper before the draft. At the end of the season, we were doing some draft specials, and he just went through a litany of players who have high-end talent, high-end skill, size, speed. And in today's game, certainly it's a speed game, it's a skill game, and there are going to be those type of players available at six for sure.
All right, Steve Yzerman was introduced as the next Red Wings general manager on April 19th. He certainly hit the ground running. He knows what the job entails as he comes back here to Detroit. But there was a pause and a reminder to all Red Wing fans, patience.
It takes time, and I caution everyone and temper the excitement that this is going to take time. I cannot give you a specific linear timeline, but we will do the things necessary. We'll take the approach that I believe and that I've learned from Ken Holland through and learn with the Ilitches through our experiences, that we follow the process, we do our job right, and truthfully, we get a little bit of luck, we'll get back to where we need to, where we're expecting to be.
He's patient, but he's not afraid to pull the trigger. We know that about Steve Yzerman. It is one of the things that we have marveled about watching him work his magic, Trev, in Tampa Bay.
It's one of the things I'm looking forward to as well, to see what kind of aggressive moves he makes. He's not going to sit on his hands. He's not going to wait around for this rebuild. He's going to force the issue a little bit, and that's going to be interesting with the guys he acquires and the pieces that he moves and exactly how he does it.
And the Red Wings with the second round picks this year with three in the second, and Steve Yzerman, as we've seen, when he moved down to get Anthony Cirelli, who's been a pretty darn good player, he moved down in that draft with the New York Islanders, who gave up 28 to go 33-72. And then he gets Anthony Cirelli that low in the draft, and the Islanders took Anthony Beauvillier. So he's been known to move down in the draft to get more picks, too. And Ken Holland did a lot of that, too. And there are some adjustments to make there with so many picks that he has.
Or don't we lose sight of the fact how many players find their way to the National Hockey League level from the second and third and fourth rounds? That certainly hasn't been the case here in Detroit as to what we had hoped it to be. But it certainly exists throughout the NHL and certainly existed with Kucherov and the likes in Tampa.
Well, certainly. And that used to be the hallmark of Detroit. drafting. I mean, you know, we always hear about Datsyuk, Zetterberg. Jonathan Erickson was Mr. Irrelevant in the NHL draft, the last player taken, and, you know, has been a Red Wing for many years. I think the thing to look at with Steve is that this situation, and I think while he preached patience, this situation a little different. When he walked into Tampa, he had Victor Hedman and Steven Stamkos, two of the most premier players in the National Hockey League. So, but again, and this is going to Trevor's point, I'm pretty sure, you know, he got rid of Martin St. Louis, Vincent LeCavalier, and they were godlikes in Tampa. I mean, they were really faces of the franchise and very prominent players. And, you know, Steve's all business. I think that's the thing. I mean, he's not going to mess around. So I'm real curious to see, once he really gets a feel for this organization, what he does. What Steve Yzerman said on April 19th about, well, let's be patient, we're going to see in the draft, and we're not going to spend this, we're not going to do that. I think once he gets in the room, once he gets a feel for this team, I think you're going to see Steve Yzerman go to work.
He knew what he was getting into when he decided to come back to Detroit and take the job that Ken Holland moved aside to allow Yzerman to take. So what does Yzerman inherit here in Detroit? What are the building blocks now as the Wings look toward what's next? We'll talk of that when we continue from here in the Red Wings dressing room on Fox Sports Detroit.